Boiling frog syndrome is a metaphor for the acceptance of large-scale, disastrous change as long as the pace of that change is incremental enough so we don't really notice it. Often this is demonstrated through boiling a frog. Put a frog in a pot of boiling water and it will jump out. Put it in a pot of room temperature water and slowly increase the heat, the frog won't notice until it's too late. This has been extrapolated to human behavior in the face of climate change, Nazism, communism, abusive relationships, and in the case of the 1997 disaster flick Dante's Peak, impending volcanic eruption. But in recent years, the reality of boiling frog syndrome has come under scrutiny. Just as ostriches don't really stick their head in the sand, frogs don't sit idly by in heated pots of water waiting to die. Luckily for us, this has been tested a number of times throughout history. In 1869, Frederick Goltz, a German scientist, removed the brain of a frog. He then put the brainless frog in a pot of water and slowly heated it until the water was boiling. The frog soon died. Nothing surprising there. There are a number of problems with this experiment beyond the brutal torture and murder of an innocent frog. It really is a poor demonstration of boiling frog syndrome. Lacking a brain, the frog really had no chance. Goltz wasn't trying to test boiling frog syndrome anyway. He was trying to find the soul. A popular theory at the time was that it was in the spinal cord. Removing the frog's brain was a way to test that. If the seat of the soul truly was in the frog's spine, you'd expect it to jump out of the boiling water, brain or not. Since the frog didn't jump, Goltz concluded the soul must be in some other part of the frog. Anyway, Goltz had the wherewithal to try and boil an unmutilated frog. This time, the frog jumped out of the water before it got hot enough to kill it. Despite this, Goltz never found the frog's soul. But it doesn't end there. The experiment was repeated a few years later by another scientist. This time the water was heated over a 90-minute period. The temperature change was gradual enough that the frog did not jump out. The experiment was repeated again by a third party and the results were the same. Boiled frog. So if you heat the water slowly enough, you can boil a frog alive. Or not. Modern scientists doubt these results. They claim that there's just no way to keep a frog still enough in a heated pot of water. Frogs have what biologists like to call a critical thermal maximum. As the temperature of the water increases, so does the temperature of the frog. As a result, the frog becomes more and more active until it inevitably leaps out of the pot. If it can get out, it will. Thus, boiling frog syndrome is a metaphor and nothing more. At least with frogs. Humans are a different story. The temperature of our planet is rising. Our metaphorical pot is getting literally hotter. Depending on how quickly we react, boiling human syndrome might turn out to be an actual thing, and unfortunately, we can't just jump out of this pot. But unlike the poor frogs in these experiments, we're actually in control. Let's hope we have the brains to do something about it before it's too late. Or we could just bury our heads in the sand. Special thanks to our Patreon patrons. Without you, the good stuff just wouldn't happen. So if you like what we do here, go on over to patreon.com/thegoodstuff and become a supporter. Otherwise, you can like and subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell so you know when the next video is coming out, and I'll be back in a couple weeks with a new video. Thanks for watching.